and I first met back in the fall of 2009, and in our meeting, he told me a bit about his history and explained that he was there the opening night in February of 66 when the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Orchestra made their debut at the Village Vanguard. These are really some of the holy grail as far as jazz recordings go. These recordings were made by George when he was 19 years old. This is really a big part of George's legacy, and it's a thrill for us to present these recordings officially for the very first time.
I was called by Alan Grant, a DJ on WABC-FM. He asked me if I would be willing to record a new band put together of all-star jazz musicians under Thad Jones and Mel Lewis. They were going to play the first time on February 7th, 1966 at the Vanguard in New York. So I was 19 years old, still a teenager, and luckily had some experience with live recording already. And I only had 6 microphones, a 2-track recorder, earphones, and some mic stands. Basically, that's all I had. I was faced with a lot of technical difficulty, and everything had to be done in the moment correctly. There was no sound check. They just set up and started playing. I had my mic set up, and I got sounds. And I was wondering, what is this music going to be? This is new music. And then the first tune started, and when I started to hear it, I was absolutely amazed. It was so special. It was as if I was hearing something new. It was brilliant, it was exciting, it was wonderful.
That Thad and Mel's group changed the way that big band performed and how composers wrote for large ensembles?
I don't think there's any doubt about it. I think that as far as playing through the music, everybody found a special place for all of those pieces of music, and Thad was still writing, still bringing in other stuff. Boy, when you think about those things, we all felt very privileged about it. I wasn't at all disappointed about anything. You know, just happy to be there.
Maybe you want to talk a little bit about the first rehearsals. What was it like? What was going on?
Well, the personnel was great. I mean, the first note we hit was amazing right there. And Thad was amazed, too. He'd never had his own band before like that, ever, you know, and it was coming together really amazing. And the first rehearsal started at midnight, and Thad had never studied conducting, but he knew how to conduct his own music, and he was a great conductor.
The audience was so respectful and just were awed by what they were hearing. We were awed by what we were doing. Everybody, including the musicians, were awed every night. The music was so fulfilling, spiritually fulfilling.
John Richardson.
What we've been able to accomplish has been really special, mostly in part to all the great musicians that we got to talk to. Jerry Dodgion, Eddie Daniels, Tom McIntosh, Jimmy Owens, Marv Holladay, the list goes on and on. Richard Davis, you know, all these people gave us their time and their knowledge of the events, especially of opening night, February 7th, 1966. Thad and Mel wanted to start a band that would carry on the legacy of Ellington, of Count Basie, of Woody Herman, that would have a forward-thinking jazz ensemble that would take the music to the next level of innovation. So when they started rehearsals Thanksgiving of 1965, they weren't messing around. Thad brought his charts that he'd written for Count Basie, that Basie didn't feel were right for his band. Thad brought that music and a lot of whiskey, because it was a celebration. They were celebrating the music and getting the band together, and everybody was excited to be a part of that band. You know, it was meant to be a jazz ensemble performing group from the beginning, and they did exactly that.
Resonance Records is proud to announce the release of Thad Jones' Mel Lewis Orchestra, All My Yesterdays, the debut 1966 recordings at the Village Vanguard. This first official release of these recordings captured the Thad Jones' Mel Lewis Orchestra in their opening night performance at the legendary Village Vanguard in New York City on February 7, 1966. Also included in this package is a second performance taken place at the Vanguard on March 21, 1966. This album is a deluxe 2-CD set and includes a 92-page book with essays and interviews from all living members of the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Orchestra, including Garnett Brown, Eddie Daniels, Richard Davis, Jerry Dodgion, Marv Doc Holladay, Jimmy Owens, Tom McIntosh, Jim McNeely, and John Mosca.
I think this is some of the most important music in the history of jazz. This is a real moment, or several moments, in the history of jazz. And I think that this is the way, a new way to arrange music and write music for a big band.
This album celebrates the 50th anniversary of the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Big Band. Now known as the Vanguard Jazz Orchestra, the band still to this day continues the tradition and legacy by celebrating this music and performing it on a weekly basis at the Village Vanguard in New York.
What's the most wonderful thing is that you will feel like you're there. The ambience, the sounds of the musicians, of Thad, he's grunting and egging them on, come on, and clapping, and all sorts of things were going on. It was a very happy and beautiful time that they had, and they loved it.
Mel Lewis is right here now because we wanted to just talk about something which I think is pretty important that Mel is pretty happy about.
Our big band.
That's a big band thing.
Tom is ready for a big band. It's an exciting band. It's new. It sounds like a big band. You know, you don't hear big bands so much anymore now. You know, they don't write for big bands. Thad writes for a big band. Thad and Bob Brookmeyer do the writing for the band, and they know how to write for a band.
Well, we do hope any of our listeners come by. Thank you, Mel.
Right,
one of our great, beautiful drummers. Mel Lewis.